Hey there, friends and frenemies. It's Walker with DIWHY.LIFE, and in this episode, we're in my garage, specifically my 2017 Honda Clarity EV. Now, if you haven't seen the video on my Clarity EV, check out the card in the upper right. All right, today we're going to be making some DIY dash cams out of some devices you probably already have laying around the house. First, we're going to make one out of an old iPhone. Then we're going to try a GoPro. And last, I'll talk about 360 dash cams. Before we get started, I just want to mention, I'm still doing my zip tie challenge for 300 subscribers, and I think we're up to 270. So I only need 30 more to be able to take this bad boy off. So help me out, subscribe to the channel. Thanks a lot. All right, first, we're gonna do the iPhone. Now you can probably use an Android. This is one I just had, it's got a broken screen. You know, how many of these do you have in your drawer? Why don't you leave me a comment below? I think I had like four of these things in my drawer. This is a real old, I think it's a 4S or something. The cool thing about this was I was actually able to find a dash cam app on the Apple, the App Store, and download it onto the phone, and it actually ran. I think the app was so old and the phone is so old that they like matched up perfectly and worked. So I'm really surprised about that. The application is called Dashcam, so you can search that up. There is a free version, and it's pretty feature-rich. I'm impressed. It has the ability to select how much of the phone's memory you want to allocate to the application, which is nice. Also, it's kind of like a DVR in that as it adds files and starts to fill up, it starts throwing away old files to make room for new ones, which is really nice. There's a lot of stands for phones, but I found these like cord tamer things that snap on here pretty good, and they got sticky bottoms. The thing about using iPhones or phones in general is their angle of view isn't very wide, so I'd recommend getting a wide angle lens to just snap on there. This one happens to be magnetic and it just goes right on there like that. Also, these things are not meant to run in the sun for very long. They're gonna get hot and overheat, so I recommend making a little shade for your device. I just cut this out of foam core board and gave it a nice shaded area so that when it's sitting up on the dash like that, it's shaded from the sun, it won't overheat. Let's give the iPhone a test. Let's put on our shade. Now you'll notice the shade is actually in the frame a little bit at the top, and that's fine because nothing typically happens in the sky up there anyways, and it's doing a good job of shading the sun. If we take the shade off real quick, that's what it looks like without the shade, and then with our shade put back on. Nice thing is it actually tells me how fast I'm going. Not super accurate, it's 3 or 4 miles per hour off, but it's kind of cool. The shade even makes the screen easier to see, which is neat. So here's what it looks like without the wide angle lens. It's a much narrower field of view. Still fairly useful though. Next, we'll try an old GoPro. I think this is a Hero 3 Silver. It shoots HD, and the cool thing about GoPros is they already have a super wide lens on them, so you don't need an adapter. The downside to using GoPros is that there's no file management, so as it fills up and gets full, you gotta take the SD card out, put it in your computer, and erase it. Also, if you don't wanna mess with charging the batteries all the time, you're going to want to use a USB cable to keep it powered. That. We get our little shade. The GoPro, the nice thing about the GoPro is it's very small. I barely notice that they're sitting on the dash, which is kind of nice. and there's no screen looking at me to distract my eyes. The last thing I want to talk about is using 360 cameras as dash cams. Now, I know you probably don't have any of these laying around in your drawers, but they are getting a lot cheaper. And this Theta by Ricoh, this one only shoots HD and it's under $200. So they are affordable. Now, the great thing about using 360 cameras as dash cams is they can see all around in your car. They can see your passengers, they can see behind you. So if somebody rear ends you, there's a chance they can catch that. The sides, so you're covered in all directions. The downside is you have to manage all the files yourself. As it fills up, you have to put the SD card in your computer and delete all the old files. Also, it's kind of a big thing sitting on top of your dash as you drive. It's a little bit of an annoyance. Oh, almost forgot our little shade. That's about all I have for this episode. If you like this video, hit that like button. Thanks for watching, and we will see you next time.